Developed by Dr. Jessica Mary Kosuro, the Sabini Woman Alternative Rite of Passage, SWAROP document is intended to empower the Sabini Cultural Institution to eliminate female genital mutilation. The 2010 Female Genital Mutilation Act outlawed the circumcision of girls as a rite of passage into adulthood and therefore criminalizes the practice that is secretly being carried out in the six districts of the Bay region. Kosuro says people are still holding on to FGM simply because they do not have an alternative.
So we, as a cultural institution, we developed this alternative rite of passage called SWAROP. That is Sabini Women Alternative Rite of Passage, because of the persistent practice of female genital mutilation among Sabini girls and women.
The SWAROP curriculum will see girls equipped with a number of skills such as family management, reproductive health, entrepreneurial skills, among others, to prepare them for the marriage institution as opposed to FGM, which only focuses on the mutilation of reproductive body parts. Once implemented, these trainings will last 2 weeks and participating girls will be issued certificates as proof that they are full women.
Because we are no longer mentoring Sabine girls for Sebei only. We are mentoring them to live in the greater world globally. And so this alternative rite of passage has skills, values, views and opinions that will equip the Sabini girl for a better role in society.
During a multi-sectoral meeting organized by Action Aid International Uganda and the UNPA in Kampala, Dr. Kosuro, however, disclosed that the Sabini Cultural Institution does not have the financial muscle to fund the SWAROP implementation. Currently, the institution is making modalities that will help them raise the required funds.
But for the piloting, if somebody gave us like 3 billion or 2 billion to start with, so that we pilot it, because we shall be training them for 2 weeks for the 6 weeks.
The institution, the cultural leaders, like for example, we agreed, how we can get some of these monies. Every clan makes an annual subscription of 1 million shillings. Every clan.
In the same meeting, Richard Chitio, a senior social development officer at the Ministry of Gender, Labour and Social Development, lauded the Sabini Cultural Institution for efforts made in the fight against FGM, but asked them to make ARP curriculum available to Sabinis living out of the 6th district of Sebei region.
We need to speak one language. If someone is training in the upper belt of Kapchoro and another one in the middle belt, and another one is training in the lower belts, they should be transmitting the same message.
Female genital mutilation is an internationally recognized violation of the human rights of girls and women. Although globally, the prevalence of FGM is declining, the practice still affects around 200 million women across the world. According to the latest Uganda Demographic and Health Survey 2016, the prevalence of FGM in Uganda remains one of the lowest in East Africa at 0.3% among women aged 15 to 49 years. Samuel Ononge, a project officer at Action Aid Uganda, explains why it is important to have the ARP document implemented as soon as possible.
We had to bring the cultural leaders from Sebei, religious leaders from Sebei, and the consultant who has been spearheading the preparation of the documents, and then the ministry officials to ensure that the input on the documents, which they have actually done, and we appreciate that.
Report compiled by Rachel Nachwala for the news.